Welcome back to the Bass Bench. Today I want to look at polishing frets. We're going to look at how to do that, and it's going to be a shootout between three different methods to polish the frets to see if there's actually any difference between the three methods. So the one method we have is the old school method of steel wool, which is very controversial to some people. So we're going to look at that, some special precautions that have to go with doing that with the steel wool. We also have this from Music Nomad. It's Frine Fret Polishing Kit. And this is a kit that comes with a few extra things that are actually quite nice. Three of them being these guards that go over the frets when you polish them. It also comes with this fret polish, and it comes with a polishing cloth as well. So we're gonna use that. And the last one we have here is actually this craft paper. It's this polishing paper, and it comes in six different grits from Coarse to Fine. So we're gonna try that as well. And essentially what I'm gonna do, I have these three frets here, 6, 7, and 8, and I'm gonna polish them individually with each one. So we're gonna use the steel wool here. We'll use this Music Nomad fret polishing, what do they call it? Frine here. And then on number 8, we're gonna use this paper. So first things first is that maybe you don't want to buy this kind of stuff, these like things, right? To be honest, they're pretty cheap. I think it was like 25 bucks for this little kit. So that's like an all-in-one solution, but we'll see how well it works. But if you don't want to do that, the classic method is to use masking tape to go over top of the fretboard to make sure you don't scuff it up, because by its nature, if you're going to be polishing, you're going to be scratching. So essentially what's going to happen if you don't cover this, you might get some damage on the fretboard that you don't want to have. So this is the old school method. And I'm going to just put this on there on frets number 6, kind of over between 5 and 7, because that's where we're going to be using that steel wool. The steel wool is definitely going to be more abrasive than the other ones, in my opinion, but we'll actually see what happens. So essentially you want to get as close to that fret as possible with the tape on either side to make sure that you aren't going to be scratching it up. Pretty easy to do, just lay it on there. And another concern you're going to have with the steel wool is that it creates particulates that can get in places you don't want them to be, specifically around these here. You don't want them to end up in the pickups because these are magnets, right? There's magnets inside there, and that's going to attract that steel. They'll get in there, they can get underneath, and that can actually cause corrosion around the coils. It can be a mess. That being said, I've done it for years. I've never had an issue once with it ever. So take that as you will. But the precautions are going to have to do with this craft paper covering this, making sure you have extra tape on top. So if you're just covering these magnets on top, around the sides as well, to make sure that you're not going to get any crap in there. But that's definitely the biggest downside with steel wool. The upside maybe, you already have it in your house and it works. It does work. Like I said, I've used it for years. So anyways, we got that pretty much covered. Just a little extra there between the 5th and 6th fret. Did I say 6th? What am I, British? Jesus. Anyways, so at this point, you might think, okay, I'm ready to go ahead and start polishing with this steel wool. But the problem is that it's, like I said, there's gonna be particulates and that's gonna fall under here. And I really don't wanna get this on the blanket. So we're prepared for that. Craft paper. Hopefully that's gonna catch most of the debris coming down. And just in case, I'm gonna put a little extra tape on here. You know, we're not doing the entire fretboard, so it's not gonna be a huge deal, but let's just cover it up. And of course, first thing is first, I didn't even say this at the beginning of the video, but you gotta take the strings off. But all you have to do is make sure they're off the headstock and you can leave them hanging down here like that. That's not a big deal. All right, so now we're ready to polish this fret and we're gonna use this super fine. So you can just take a piece of it. It's really easy. You just rub it back and forth. See, look at that. I don't know if you can see this. Maybe you can see it with the HD cam pointed down here, but how much crap has already come off just from me pulling a piece off of this larger chunk of steel wool. I want to get this out of here. And I'm going to go ahead and say that this has become my least favorite way to polish frets. I know I've done it in the past. I've done it even in one of the videos on this channel, but all in all, not the best way to do it. But anyways, all you have to do is rub it back and forth. Try to get it right to the edge of that fret And what we're gonna see is probably a slight difference in the polish of this fret from before and after. And I can already see the difference. And now, wow, it looks good. I had polished these frets maybe 3 or 4 months ago, so they still look pretty good. The thing about polishing frets is this is one of those neglected things sometimes that people don't realize can be done, or maybe even needs to be done, because what happens when you polish it, not only does it feel better when you play, when the strings rub against the fret, it's nice and smooth, right? That's really nice, and it feels good to play the guitar. It's gonna feel just more fresh and clean and smooth, and it's great. But the other thing that it does is it gives that bass a little extra je ne sais quoi when it's hanging on the wall. It's just gonna look prettier, and most people, when they look at it, they're not gonna know what it is. That's the difference. But the shine of those frets off from the lights that are coming down on it really make it sparkle. Really shine and sparkle. It's really nice. So yeah, you can polish it for as long as you want. And I'm not gonna spend all day doing this. Just a minute or two. And already, right there, we can see that it is shinier than the ones beside it. I don't know how well that's gonna pick up on here. We're gonna do a little thing after. We can get a close up on the frets, 6, 7, and 8, to see what they look like. But it looks pretty decent. So I think that's good for the steel wool. And what I wanna do is actually clean up some of this crap and start with the other compounds. And it's such a pain in the butt because look at, there's particulates all over the frets that I didn't cover, all over the place, and underneath the guitar here, all over here, there's a bunch of crap that has fallen down. And that's what sucks about this method, but it does work. If you're in a pinch, say you live somewhere where you're not close to a music store, or maybe even, well, I guess you can just order most of the stuff from Amazon anyways, but say you're like me and you like to support your local friendly music store, this could be a thing to do. That's your local hardware store. Anyways, I'm gonna get this removed off and we're gonna move on to the Frine. All right, moving on to the Frine. We got everything we need here. So what you gotta do is make sure you get the snuggest fit with one of these tools. And this one's just, that almost fits perfectly. It's just a bit too small. And this one's a bit too big. Now, I don't think it's gonna be a big problem. This stuff isn't gonna damage your fretboard, but it is recommended to take it off the fretboard when it gets on there. So I think we'll try with this one and see how we go. So what you need to do is actually shake this bottle up first. It's pretty viscous in there. I don't think this is gonna do a big deal to it, but we'll try our best. And you're gonna put a little bit of this, a little bead of this on the polishing cloth. Yeah, it's quite viscous, just like that. And what you wanna do is make sure that this is over top. Oh, geez. And get that across there. Give it a polish. So we're gonna do the same thing, just rubbing that fret from one end to the other. All right, so I don't know how this is picking up on camera, but to my eye, this Frine definitely worked better than the steel wool. It looks like it's reflecting more, has a more mirror-like finish on this fret over the one we did with the steel wool. Yeah, it's definitely better. Not only is it better, that was most definitely easier to do. Wow, that looks really good. That looks great. I'm impressed. All right, next up is this craft paper from Zona. And what we're gonna do is just cut a few pieces off of each grit. And I'm actually gonna go from the most coarse one down to the least coarse one, the most fine grain, to see what kind of results we can get with this versus that Frine, because the Frine's the winner right now. This stuff is also quite cheap. And I think that's all I'm gonna need is one tiny little patch of each coarseness. Oh no, I have a colorblind problem. I hope I'm sorted these correctly. I don't think so. I think this is here. Okay, so like we did with the Frine, we're gonna go ahead and polish up this fret here. All right, so just after doing this first one, you can see that this stuff is actually quite coarse, and you can see that it has made it look matte. And again, I don't know how that's showing up on camera. I'll try to bring the GoPro as close as possible, but it's gone matte, which means that this might actually be the best one in the long run. It might take a little bit more work, but it seems like it's gonna get rid of any grooves or little tiny marks that are in the fret to give you the smoothest possible surface. But the thing I'm having a problem with is you can see maybe you will see it. It's scratching up the surface of this, which isn't a big deal at all. But I might actually have a better time if I'm taping this. So I'm actually gonna do that right now. All right, we're taped up. Let's get back to it. All right, and there we go. So already I can tell that this is gonna be really good over top of the last two. Holy smokes, that is really shiny. I've actually never used this paper before and it worked really well. So there you go. I'm gonna probably try to get a better glamour shot of this fret, these frets, so you can see for yourself. But you can see, so this is polished a few months ago with the steel wool, just polished with the steel wool. This was polished with the Frine, and then this one was polished with this Zona wet or dry micron graded polishing paper. So obviously, what for my eyes, what I can see is this paper worked the best. That being said, it took the longest and I had to use that tape on there as well. So it actually takes a little bit of time to do the whole fretboard, a lot longer than the other ones. So let's say you like to service your guitar every year or two, might be a good idea if you get some corrosion here or the frets are not looking so good to take the time, you know, get all that paper or the tape on here and really polish those frets with the paper. That being said, if you want a quick polish, I think this Frine is going to be the way to go. It's really easy to use and man, it looked great in just a minute, just a quick second doing the polishing using these guards. Fantastic. Fantastic product. I really like that. So I'm going to be using both of these methods depending on the situation. As far as it goes with the steel wool, throw that stuff in the trash. It is just, it creates a mess. It can create problems with the pickups. You don't want that. Don't do it. So that's all I have for this video. Thanks for watching. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comments. We'll see you next time.